What? No! You gotta be kidding me!
Yep, ready to roll.
Yep, yep, just one sec. Gotta get to the save point. Jump! Jump! Kick! Kick! What? Huh? Take that, Ganon! Harl is mine! Ready now. Hey there, I'm Liz, a software engineer here at Canva, otherwise known as SimDimLim, to my gaming buddies. If you're into gaming and streaming, then you know a good gamer logo is key for gaining audience trust and building a fan base. This wasn't always the way, but now with sponsors, developers, content creators, and gaming professionals, it's more competitive than ever. You need to stand out, and a solid logo can help you do that across all the platforms. Think of it this way, a visual identity can send direct messages to your target audience within seconds of seeing your brand. They'll pick up subtle cues, what you stand for, and your values, almost without meaning to. Much more effective than a text-based description that no one will ever read. Before I get too far into the theory, let me show you how easy it is to make a logo on Canva. And stick around to the end, and I'll show you how to make merchandise. Like this. Oh, and subscribe to the channel. We have loads of great videos with all sorts of tips and tricks dropping every week. One of the best things about Canva is the templates. There are thousands of them, and they make starting so easy. Check it out, there are so many. Anything with a crown is for Pro or Canva for Team subscribers. Or if you're a student from a participating uni or school, you get access to the Pro stuff too. Now, you can see here that every type of gamer is catered for. The stealthy snipers, the gung-ho aggressive tanks, the gotta catch 'em all achievers, or the casual gamer with attitude, like me. Once you choose a template, it's really easy to customize. Watch this. This one is great. Cute, but passionate. Double-click on the name and you can change the text. Not liking the font? That's easily changed by going here and selecting something you prefer. You can type in the style you're looking for. Or, if you know your fonts, just type the name in. Okay, that's looking good. Now, this is an image, so I can't change the colors, but I could add a background easily. Go into the Elements tab. You could select lines and shapes, but I'm gonna just search for wiggly circle. This one's perfect. Use the position tool here. Now, I can move to the back like this. And center everything with this button. I'll just make the character a little bigger and have them leaning over the name. Nice. Change the color of the background shape here. Choose something that contrasts with the bear. Great. In order to build recognition of your brand, you should try to choose a palette with two or three colors and stick to them. No more than four. Your audience will start to recognize both your graphics, the fonts, how they're laid out, and the color. There's a great color picker on this site. It has color palette ideas and a generator to help you find the perfect accessible combination. It couldn't be easier. Okay, so we've made a logo by customizing an existing template, and you saw how quick it can be. It's actually pretty quick to make one from scratch too. Check this out. Start with a simple document by searching for logo in the search field and selecting the blank option. Then I'm gonna search for dim sum in the Elements tab. Okay, I like this one. It's a pro element, so you'll need to pay a one-off fee or subscribe. There's a filled-in version or an outline. You know what? I'm gonna use both. I'll use the fill as the background and the outline on top. Now, I need a little face. I'll give you a tip. Type in kawaii face and you'll get some real cute ones that you can just add on top. Nice. Okay, now a headset. Choose something that isn't too complex. Ha, that's looking fun. Now, I liked the fonts from the template before, so I'll just copy and paste them here. Still missing something. What about this? Yeah, that's working. Another one here, and I'll choose the same color as the cheeks by using the color picker, like this. Cute! I'll add a simple background like this. And we're good to go. This logo is easy to remember, and it's gonna make a solid first impression for my audience, hopefully converting them into loyal fans. And what I like about it is it's got some room to move. Like, say I do start to get some fans and I want them to feel like they belong to something larger. Or maybe I start playing with the team. This logo could easily evolve to include them. Check it out. I'll duplicate this logo and I'm gonna get rid of some of the elements. Now, I saw another graphic when I was searching before that I liked. It's already got a face on it too. I'll change the name a little bit. What could it be? What about Fam for Family? And maybe make this shape shorter by grabbing this handle here. Nice, I'm happy with this. Okay, so what now? I have a brand and a team logo too. What's next? Well, assuming I do start to develop a following, having some merchandise might be a good idea. It allows people to show their support and earns me some money as well. First, I'll start with a sticker. I can copy and paste my logo in here. Okay, it looks all right, but I'm not really using the space in the best way. Let's go back to that shape I used at the start. Ah, much better. Once a name gets known, I could even get rid of it and just have the graphic, like this. Oh, now this is getting interesting. You'll notice up here, I can hit this button and I can send this to print. It has a great little preview panel that shows you how big it will be. I think small is perfect. I want it in gloss. Choose how many stickers you want. Wow, individually, they become pretty cheap the more you get. And that's it. It'll be on its way to you in about 7 days. Perfect to give out at gamer cons or events I attend. What other merchandise could I have available? Oh, t-shirts. Start with a blank t-shirt by searching for one from the homepage. Copy in your designs. I want it to be a two-sided shirt, so I'll put the name on the front, like this, and create a new page. On the back, I'll come up with a graphic that incorporates the logos. Nice, that should work. I can look at the preview here. This design will work on a white shirt, but I want a black shirt. So I'll change the selection here and then modify the design slightly so that it stands out on the darker color. Change the name color to white. Check the preview. That looks sweet. I could add a small markup on this and everyone will be happy. Hopefully you're starting to see how easy this is. And in no time, it will arrive at your door. God, look at that. Looks amazing. All right, I'm running out of time, but just quickly, I could make a Twitch banner just by typing in Twitch banner into the search field and copying over my logo and name. Yep, looks pretty good. I could animate that as well. And maybe a logo onto my social profile. 12,000 followers? Well, I guess it's a start. If you want to see how I could make an animated Twitch banner, just let me know in the comments and I'll make a video all about it. Okay, I better get back to my game. Hey, you're still here? Have you started your logo yet? Well, don't forget to subscribe below or like and share the video so others can see it too. Maybe you want to check out some of our other videos. There's some great stuff in the playlist and we're dropping new videos every week. Or maybe you want to find me online and challenge me to a game? See you then.